Now let's continue with our two-point flip example. We have defined three events. Each event is a subset of outcomes. Here, event A is in language, and the second coin flip is a tail. And we can write exactly the same idea mathematically to say this A is a subset. It's a set of these two outcomes. And their second coin flip is a tail. Same thing for event B. We say at least one coin flip is a head. That's in language. And the mathematical language of that is to write out this collection of outcomes. So it's for this event C with a single outcome. Now we say this is a definition. We say that a event A occurs if when we run this random experiment we see an outcome omega, and that happens to be in this set A. For example, if we see tail-tail, and we say event A occurs. We see head-tail, we also say event A occurs. Well, this is an important point, that each time you run a random experiment, there can be only one outcome. But there could be multiple events happen at the same time. For example, if we see this head-tail as our outcome, then it is one element in event A, so A occurs. The second coin flip is a tail. And at the same time, event B also occurs. There is at least one head in your outcome. So multiple events can occur at the same time. Now we also can define the notion of the probability of an event. What is the probability you see an event occur? Probability you see this event A occur? For example, well, then it must be that the outcome is one of its elements. So we write this as the sum over all outcomes in this set, in this event. We sum up its corresponding probability. And this sum of probability is the probability that this event A occurs. In this example, probability of event A is equal to 1/4 for this head-tail, plus another 1/4 for this tail-tail, is equal to 2/4, 1/2. That's an example of probability of an event.